Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Madhav Rathi from STEM Medica India. We are providing stem cell therapy for various diseases. I'm continuing previous section of video, that is why stem cell therapy is not routinely available, why it is not routine line of treatment, or why it is not globally accepted. So I'm giving answer here. Most importantly, stem cell therapy is under research. It's in initial stage. And because of its under research, it's not globally accepted. It will take a few years more. So now what I'm trying to say, if in case of end stage organ failure, and if that there is no hope in routine line of treatment, patient tried everything but his condition is not cured. So in that case, if that patient has one option of stem cell therapy and which doesn't have a side effect, I'm talking about autologous stem cell therapy, and somehow it create a hope, it give a result, then why do not patient try that one? Okay, because his family doctor does not recommend that one. Why he deny this research-based procedure or new technique? Because his family doctor is not recommend that one, or it is not completely established. I think the criteria of choosing this new technique must be, if there would not be any side effect, then patient has to be choose that one, and if somehow that give the result, then patient has to be choose that one. So for example, in case of kidney failure patient, there is only two options: kidney transplant or continuing dialysis. But we know that organ transplant is lengthy procedure. There has to be following a lot of documentation, then we have to wait for donor, all these things comes up. And I'm not recommending kidney transplant is 100% sure. There are plus things also, there are minus things also involved. Same is applicable to stem cell also. If that is the condition, in that case patient has to choose the stem cell therapy, then what he should check first? First, is there any side effect of this therapy? If using autologous stem cell therapy, then I can say there is no side effect at all. And secondly, if somehow that therapy give a result, then I think this is the way of choosing the treatment. Patient can choose the treatment. तो इसमें प्रॉब्लम ये है कि स्टेम सेल थेरेपी अभी तो अंडर रिसर्च है, और अंडर रिसर्च होने के कारण इट्स नॉट रूटीन लाइन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट, और ग्लोबली अभी तक एक्सेप्टेंस हुआ नहीं है, डॉक्टर्स उनको रिकमेंड नहीं करते, तो दैट आर द थिंग्स. बट अगर ऑटोलॉगस स्टेम सेल थेरेपी यूज़ करने से कोई साइड इफेक्ट नहीं है, और वो अगर रिजल्ट दे रहा है, और रूटीन लाइन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट भी कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है, क्योर नहीं है, तो मेरे ख्याल से पेशेंट को स्टेम सेल थेरेपी चूज़ करना चाहिए, एटलीस्ट ट्राई करना चाहिए. एंड सेकेंड थिंग इज, मोस्ट ऑफ डॉक्टर्स कंसल्टेंट दे आर नॉट रिकमेंडिंग एंड दे आर नॉट एडवाइजिंग पेशेंट स्टेम सेल थेरेपी. देर आर लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स involved in it. First is misconception, this misunderstanding. These doctors doesn't know, they believe on these news media channels. They doesn't have a proper knowledge of stem cell, and on that basis of this new channel and all these things, they sort out their personal opinion, and that personal opinion they put forward to patient, advise them that don't go for this, there are side effects, there is no result, all these things they are speaking. But honestly speaking, if I say, I accept that stem cell is not 100% sure, and even in medical science, no medical treatment is 100% sure. There is no guarantee, warranty. These words are not exist in medical field dictionary. So simply in case of hospitalization for just a fever, you can't say that or no doctor give you 100% guarantee for recovery, right? That is the things comes up. So simply, stem cell, this is applicable to stem cell also, but the patient has to be knowledgeable and the patient has to be decide, and don't believe on 100% of any doctors. Take a second opinion, that's most important. And for medical faculty also, if that doctor doesn't have a knowledge, then I think so, doctor should not be talk or doctor should not say wrong thing about this field also. Because if you have a proper knowledge, then on that basis you can go with that one. But say just saying that this stem cells has side effect, cancer chances and all these things without knowing properly, that is also misguiding to the patient. That is also malpractice. Doctors लोगों को भी सोचना चाहिए कि अगर उनको proper knowledge है तो according to that they patient को guide करना चाहिए, ना कि कुछ भी गलत फहमियाँ patient को फैला के उनको misguide करना चाहिए. That is also act of malpractice. Simply stem cell therapy जो है वो 100% कोई sure नहीं है. तो अगर आपको नॉलेज है तो आपको स्टेम सेल थेरेपी 100% श्योर तो है ही नहीं, और वो मैं एक्सेप्ट कर रहा हूँ. पर कुछ केसेस में उसके रिजल्ट भी बहुत अच्छे हैं. सो दीज आर टू क्वेश्चंस टुडे आई आंसर. सो थैंक यू वेरी मच.